Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the CM Worship for March the 20th, 2022. I hope you had a wonderful March break and you're ready to head back to school. How about we all stand up together and let's worship the Lord.
Tender whispers of love in
Okay, let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you that you are a good, good Father. And even when we go through good or bad circumstances, you are still good. Help us to appreciate you every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Jacob had 12 sons, but Joseph was his favorite. Jacob's other sons hated Joseph. One day, Jacob sent Joseph to check on his brothers, who were tending to the sheep. The brothers saw Joseph coming, and they made a plan to get rid of him. They sold Joseph as a servant to some travelers going to Egypt. Then they convinced Jacob that wild animals had killed his favorite son. Jacob was very sad. Meanwhile, the travelers sold Joseph to an Egyptian officer named Potiphar. The Lord was with Joseph and made him successful at everything he did. Potiphar put Joseph in charge of many things, and Potiphar was happy with him. But Potiphar's wife lied about Joseph, accusing him of doing something he didn't do. Potiphar was angry, and he put Joseph in prison. God was still with Joseph and blessed him, even in prison. God gave Joseph the ability to understand the meaning of dreams. Years passed, and Joseph was forgotten in prison until Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, had two dreams. He sent for Joseph. Joseph explained the dreams. Egypt was going to have 7 good years with plenty of food, followed by 7 bad years of no food. Joseph told Pharaoh to save food during the good years to be used during the bad years. Pharaoh realized that God was with Joseph, so he made Joseph second in command in all of Egypt. Joseph stored away food during the good years. Then, during the famine, people came to him to buy grain. One day, Jacob sent 10 of his sons to Egypt to buy grain. The brothers came to Joseph and bowed down. Joseph knew who they were, but they did not recognize him. When Joseph was ready, he told his brothers who he was. "I'm Joseph," he said. "Don't be afraid. God sent me here so I could save your people, a remnant from the famine." Joseph's brothers went home to bring all their family and belongings back to Egypt. Jacob hugged his son Joseph, and they cried. Jacob's family was blessed in Egypt, but Jacob got older and died. Now Joseph's brothers were afraid Joseph would punish them for what they did to him. Joseph said, "You planned evil against me. God planned it for good, to bring about the present result, the survival of many people." Joseph comforted his brothers and spoke kindly to them. God had a plan for Joseph's life. He allowed Joseph to suffer in order to rescue a whole nation. God planned for Jesus to suffer so that many people from all nations would be saved.
Okay, welcome back. Today we are going to learn about Joseph and the ups and downs that he went through in his life. Joseph had some very super high moments, and he also had some super low moments. So in the super low moments, he endured some suffering. So let's talk about some of those moments. So in Joseph's life, his super high moments was that he was a favorite son of his father, Jacob. He was the only one who received a multicolored coat from his dad. And when he was thrown into prison, when he was in Egypt, Joseph was the one who was in charge of the prison because God was with him. He also became the second in command after he was released from prison, and he was able to interpret Pharaoh's dreams for him. And because of his correct interpretation, he was able to store enough crops so that he could save the whole nation of Egypt from famine when they had 7 years of famine. So in Joseph's super low moments, we know Joseph was thrown into a pit and sold to the Midianites traders by his brothers for 20 pieces of silver. He was wrongly accused of hurting Potiphar's wife and was thrown into prison for that. And when the cupbearer and the baker who were in prison with Joseph were released from prison, did they remember Joseph? No, they forgot about him. So he remained in prison for a number of more years. But God had a purpose and a plan for Joseph's life. And through it all, God was still in control, and he was going to work out everything for his good. So let me start by asking you a question. Do any of you guys like sports? I'm sure that if you play sports, you know that you need to practice, right? An athlete will go through strict training to get their bodies in shape so that they can play their best. Whether they're playing a team sport or an individual sport, they need to go through the suffering or the discipline in order to be the best player that they can be. Or maybe some of you play a musical instrument. Any of you play the violin or play the piano? Well, you know, whatever musical instrument you play, whether at school or at home, you need to practice, right? And is practice fun? No, not. Most of the time, it's not fun. I remember when I was a kid, I hated to practice. I would rather play outside than go and practice a piano inside. And the one thing I didn't like when I had to practice piano was to play scales. Scales seemed like they were just a waste of time. But now that I'm an adult, I understand why we need to play scales. Do you want to hear my theory as to why I think scales are important? Well, scales help us develop rhythm. And they also help us to understand different keys of music, like the difference between an A major and G major and even C major. And they also strengthen the muscles in our fingers so that we can play our pieces better. Scales are the building blocks for music, so that's why it's important for us to practice them. And what about the Olympics? You know, we just finished the Olympics in Beijing, right? Can you imagine if there was an athlete that just competed and he had no training at all, or she? Do you think that person would be good enough to be able to win a good gold medal? I think maybe not, right? Because other athletes might have been training for 4 years, and if this person had just come in, depending on his or her natural talent to win, most likely this person would not be able to succeed. We know that natural talent will only take us so far, but hard work and discipline plus natural talent will take us further. So what am I trying to say? What I'm trying to say is that sometimes suffering or discipline is necessary to bring out the best in us. Any of you guys like to drink coffee? Well, maybe you've seen a machine like this at your home before. This is called a French press, okay? I'm gonna show you how to use a French press today. Pastor Amy loves her coffee, so she knows how to use the French press. I will show you how this works. So, first of all, if I lift this up, you'll see that this is like a plunger, okay? So this thing will push the coffee down. And well, my coffee cup is for drinking the coffee. And I also have some boiling water here, okay? And of course I have coffee grinds. Now, in order to make good coffee in the French press, we need to put the coffee grinds into the French press. So let's do that now. So usually I do it just so that it fills the bottom of the French press. Okay, like that. So the coffee grounds cannot stay beans. They have to be ground up first in the grinder before they can be be made into coffee. Okay, so we have our coffee that's in the French press. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour some water into the French press. Okay, I'm going to pour maybe about half about halfway. Okay, so I already boiled the water, so if you're wondering. And so you see how the grinds are mixing together now? Now, I'm gonna take this, which is our plunger, and I wanna make sure that this part connects to the handle here, and I'm gonna stick it in, okay? I'm not gonna press it all the way, but I'm gonna just push it about halfway until it touches the water and the grinds, okay? So I'll wait about 5 minutes, and then after 5 minutes, I'll push it all the way down, and then I'll have my cup of coffee, okay? And then I can pour it into the cup and enjoy it. So what does this have to do with our lesson for today? Well, sometimes we are like the coffee beans here. Sometimes we need to go through trials and we need to go through some suffering in order for God to bring out the best parts of who we are. And so sometimes we need to be ground up and tested. Sometimes we need to have hot water poured on us, not literally, but like trials and difficulties we need to go through. Or sometimes we need some pressure and some stress for God to bring out the best part of us. And that's exactly what Joseph went through too, right? Joseph, when he was in Egypt, he went through some suffering. He was thrown into prison. He was also accused wrongly of hurting Potiphar's wife. So these are some of the sufferings that he went through. But God used those sufferings to bring out something good in him and also to save the nation from famine. So in Romans chapter 8, verse 28, it says that God works out all things for the good of those who love God and who are called according to his purpose. Even at the end, when Joseph meets his brothers and he reveals himself to his brothers as the long-lost brother that they had sold into slavery, this is what Joseph says to his brothers. He says, "You intended to harm me, but God intended it for good, to accomplish what is now being done, the saving of many lives." So God had a plan for Joseph all along. He allowed Joseph to suffer so that he could rescue the whole nation from the famine. Nothing is outside of God's plan, whether good or bad. He is in control of all things. So as Easter approaches, we are going to reflect on how Jesus suffered for us and for our good, and how he is the one who is able to rescue us from our sins. So we'll explore that idea further as Easter approaches. So let's pray together. Father God, we know that when we go through hardship and suffering, it is never fun. But we know that you are a good, good God, and sometimes you are using suffering to bring out the best in us. Help us to be willing to endure, Lord, and help us to remember that even through suffering, you are working it out for our good so that we can become a better person. So thank you, Lord, for all that you do. In Jesus' name, amen. So let's watch the mission moment for this month.
Greetings from Spain. Many years ago, we started on a missionary journey that took us to Toronto, where in partnership with Scarborough Chinese Alliance Church, we helped plant a Hispanic church. God then led us to Mexico, where we ministered for 10 years. However, for the last 10 years, we've been serving in creative ministries in Spain. And I'm currently involved in mission leadership. And Kim is a painter, and she's ministering to non-believing artists, as she'll explain in a moment. But first off, Spain is a country comprised of several people groups like Basques, Catalans, and Galicians, and they all celebrate and maintain their unique linguistic and cultural differences. Spain in general is quite secularized and has traditionally been very resistant to the gospel message. My responsibilities include providing care and oversight to our multinational international workers who are ministering amongst Spaniards, Moroccan immigrants, sub-Saharan refugees, as well as trafficked women. I mentor Spaniards and I mentor Latin American immigrants who desire to grow deeper in their relationship with God. And I'm one of the professors in our modular Bible school whose students are future pastors and Christian leaders of the church in Spain.
Hi, I'm Kim, and this is my studio. I am an artist living here in Spain, and I have an art ministry, so I wanted to introduce you to what it is that I actually do, what it looks like. So first of all, I'm a painter, so I have to paint. And one of the things that I choose to do is paintings that have a message, have a meaning. And what better message than Bible stories? So like this one is Daniel and the Lion's Den, just kind of a modern version of it. Paintings that will start the question of why? What does this mean? What is it talking about? So I have a lot of communication with my artist friends. We go out, we talk about how it is to be created in the image of God. What does that mean? What does it look like? And as beings who are created in his likeness, we are made to create. And as artists, that's just really, really important. So here, this is where I sit and I paint. And this is where I pray for my friends. And I pray for you too.
So how can you pray for God's work in Spain? First, you can pray for a new generation of godly leaders who know God and who are committed to the truth of the gospel and who are truly gospel-centered. Pray for more workers, more faithful workers, that the door remains open. We can minister freely here and we can make the most of our opportunity. Pray for the conversion of Spaniards as well and Spaniards from other countries. Pray for the artists of Spain and of Europe. They really need Jesus. Thank you very much for your time. God bless you.
Let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, we remember Kim and Kurt Peters, who have been serving in Spain for the past 10 years. Please bless Kurt while he's ministering among Spaniards and teaching future pastors and Christian leaders of the Spanish churches. We pray for the conversion of Spaniards as well. O Lord, please make use of Kim's art ministry. Grant her wisdom and strength to share the gospel with other artists. We pray that the Peters can minister freely in Spain and make the most of their opportunities. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Okay, just a few announcements for this week. Summer camp at SCAC is now open. Please register and reserve your spots for our in-person camps. We have 5 weeks of camp. You can ask Priscilla or Janet for more details if you would like to join us this summer. Second announcement is about Lent. So Priscilla and I will be sending you some Lent materials for this week. This week is week number 3 of Lent. We hope these materials will be useful to you and your family. Okay, let's stand up and let's receive the benediction for this week. In the spirit of St. Patrick's Day, we will end with an Irish prayer. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Amen. Have yourself a great week and see you next Sunday. Okay, kids, I'm sure that you're curious to wonder what happened to the coffee, right? Since I didn't push down the plunger yet. So let me do it now. So it's been about 5 minutes. I'm going to push down the plunger and all the coffee grinds will go down to the bottom, okay? All right, I'm going to pour it into the coffee cup. And now we have a great cup of coffee. I will enjoy. He is true. Life, he is Lord.